Hey, I've been getting a lot of messages of people asking me what's the difference between a preview or let's say a 1:1 preview and a smart preview. By the way, can I please request you to subscribe to this channel so that you get all the updates that we send? Also, it's a good idea to hit the bell icon so that you get instant notifications when we have new content. So I'd like to explain that in a quick video here. So when you actually import images into your Lightroom's catalog, it is supposed to create a preview of this raw file. If you understand, Lightroom doesn't store the raw file. It actually routes the raw file through Lightroom to its destination, which could be an external hard disk. But inside of Lightroom, it creates a small preview of the raw file, which is what you can see in a screen like this. Right now, you're seeing a lot of thumbnails on my screen. These are actually previews of the raw file, which is in the form of a thumbnail here. Now, if you've noticed, when you double click on an image and when you actually press the letter Z, or when the magnifying glass is appearing as the cursor for you, and if you press on this, it enlarges the image and shows this image in the 100% view. The 100% actually means the 1:1 perspective, or it's actually showing you how big this image actually is. If it's actually a 5,000 pixel wide image, you'll be able to scroll and see the entire area of this image when you open it in 1:1. And if you actually press Z back, or if you press the magnifying glass again, it's going to show you a fitting into the screen kind of a perspective. Now, this is what is called as a 1:1 perspective. In other words, if you open all the 5,000 pixels at once and see, it'll actually show you, depending on the resolution of your monitor, how many pixels it can, but it's going to call this a 1:1 perspective or 1:1 resolution of this image. But a smart preview is completely different. What a smart preview actually means is, you might know that you have to attach your hard disk, which has the raw file, for you to actually go ahead and get into the develop module and start working on your files. Because if you don't have the hard disk attached, you might have noticed that Lightroom's thumbnail in the library view, which would have an exclamation mark, and when you mouse over the exclamation mark, it would tell you that the photo is missing. And when you get into the develop module, when you want to edit your images, it'll say file could not be found. That is because your raw file is not connected to Lightroom. Now, it could be a situation where you're actually flying from point A to point B and you don't have your hard disk attached to your Lightroom. And in this case, if you want to spend your time on the flight and you want to edit a few pictures, since your hard disk is not attached, it's very difficult for you to actually edit them. So Lightroom rescues you by allowing you to create something called as a smart preview. A smart preview is actually, let's say, a mini raw file sitting inside your catalog itself. What it allows you to do is change your image when you go to the develop settings, irrespective of whether your raw file was connected or not. In fact, if it's not connected, it'll use its internal smaller mini raw file that it has, which is what I call it as a mini raw file. You can actually change your settings on the raw file even without your raw file actually connected, because that is what it does by using an internal data storage file called as a smart preview. Now, the advantage of doing this is when you're not connected to the hard disk, you can make changes. Once you land, you connect your hard disk, this smart preview is updated and you actually get the entire file preview later on. Please understand, if you have worked on smart previews, when you export your files, you would not be able to export it in the 100% resolution of how you shot it. In fact, a smart preview only allows you to publish your picture, I think approximately around 2000 something pixels wide, which is good enough to post online, but perhaps not use it to print. So I'd look at smart previews as not a way to actually be processing images unless you want to quickly work on your raw files while on the move. A lot of such information like smart previews and previews and all of these is covered in a comprehensive course on Lightroom Classic CC, which you can actually buy. And the link to this course is provided in the description below. And for more videos like this and informative sessions and nuggets every week, please subscribe to the Toehold TV channel.